The players, and even coaches perhaps, find it impossible to completely forget about the game. And now, with all that has gone before out of mind, it is indeed time for the game. It's the Action Sports presentation of High School Football 92. Tonight, the Reidsville Rams host the Morehead Panthers, each perfect in the conference, and the winner likely takes the conference crown. Action Sports High School Football 92 is brought to you by Sara Lee Knit Products.
And hello everybody, Bruce Michaels here at Rams Stadium, and what you are seeing is unique. The Rams marching band, the Panthers marching band, the two of them interweaving. As you can see, they will each play tonight's national anthem. Actually, it's the national anthem every night, but they will be doing it together, and I believe this is a first. We're glad to be with you this evening. This, of course, is the game every year. Morehead, Reidsville, Reidsville, Morehead, every year this is the game, and this year it is especially relevant because the two are unbeaten, the only teams in the conference that are unbeaten, and as a result of that, tonight's winner in all likelihood takes the conference crown. We'll pause now for the national anthem. Gentlemen, in the true spirit of sportsmanship, the two marching bands together performing the Star Spangled Banner. We'll come back in a moment and give you the highlights and the lineups and things like that. Stay with us. It's a big night in Rams country. And we're back, and as you can see, the Rams band is still on the field. The Morehead Panthers are coming out of the field from the far end. And you're going to hear a lot of noise tonight. Ken, this is it's always an extravaganza when these two teams get together, but tonight they are unbeaten in conference play. They are literally playing for it.
Well, as you say, Bruce, it's a great rivalry and always is, no matter what the circumstances, but the circumstances tonight make it oh so special. Each team has lost one game, those losses outside the conference. This game will certainly decide who's in first place in the conference right now. Will all, in all probability, decide who finishes in first place in the Triad 3A. We've got a big crowd now and a lot of folks still coming in, and a lot of excitement in the air.
Looking to park, is that right?
Yes, in fact, I looked to park for a while myself.
Yes. Well, we talked to the coaches this week, of course, and both of them know what is at stake here. They both view it as a big game. We talked first to Rams coach Jimmy Teague, and let's hear what he had to say.
Yeah, we're excited just to be able to play in a tight game like this. Like I told our kids on Monday, you don't get a chance to play for the college championship very often, and hopefully the winner of this one probably will be in line to do that. But, you know, you still got to play two more after that. But it is a big game.
It's a big game, a master of understatement indeed. And there you see the Panthers running onto the field, and the Morehead side reacts. Big game tonight. They have probably brought before, well, they're still looking apart. Before it's all said and done, they will probably have brought 3,000 as visitors, and no telling what's going to be over here on the Reidsville side before it's all done.
Oh, yeah, they brought, I'm pretty sure they brought that many, because there are a couple of thousand over there now, and people still streaming in. And we very likely will have people arriving still, even after the game has started, because there's quite a bit of parking congestion out there. A lot of people are looking for a place to park, and many of them, when they find that place to park, they're going to have a long walk to get in the gate.
Yes, indeed.
And tonight, I'm sorry, Bruce.
That's all right. The captains are coming out. We'll be able to watch them flip the coin.
Tonight, Reidsville is in all blue. Last week, they wore all gold for the first time in 31 years. Tonight, they wear all blue. I don't know if they've ever worn all blue. We'll have to ask Dale Hegwood when we get a chance.
Well, they've worn white. They've worn white and blue. They've worn blue on. I mean, it's just it's kind of interesting. You never know which team is going to show up, which look is going to show up, but they look good, and I wonder if there's not perhaps a certain psychological ploy involved here. You know, a lot of the teams that wear black, the Raiders and teams like that, like to wear their dark uniforms. The Steelers, here come the Rams. They will pound through the banner. Boom, boom. A lot of noise. A lot of excitement. Well, as we said, we did talk to the coaches. And we'll hear what Coach Clayton Johnson had to say a little bit later. But let's see who's going to win the toss. That's going to be paramount. I don't know if you can hear me, Ken.
I can hear you a little bit. I'm not sure what you said, but I did know you were talking.
It's going to be a fun night. All right, let's see. And Morehead has won the toss and has elected to receive, and they will defend the north goal. And we will take a break and come back with the kickoff right after this. Real quick, let's hear what Coach Clayton Johnson had to say.
This is what you play for late in the year. To line up and play big games like this, this is what it's all about. Reidsville's got a great team. We got a great team. I much rather be at this stage of the game in the season, lining up and playing such an important ball game, you know, that so important for both football teams, than I had, you know, not having that opportunity. So this should be a great experience for our football team and their football team. And whoever wins the game, I'm sure this experience is going to help both of us when we do line up for the playoffs.
Sure.
It's unfortunate one of us is going to win, one's going to lose, and I hope that we're on the winning note, and if we're not, then we'll congratulate Reidsville, and we'll finish our season and hope we get a shot in the playoffs.
We're set to kick off. Ronald Wilson, whom last weekend we saw boot several into the end zone, is set to kick off and set back. And deep safety, we've got Chris Moyer and Chris Petty, the crisscross.
It was three, I believe, he kicked into the end zone last week, Bruce.
I don't see any wind. He may do it again tonight. And we're set to go. This game is underway. Short kick this time, taken by one of the up men. And in fact, moving quickly, that is Lamont Duncan, the fullback.
Duncan took the ball at the 19-yard line as we have an injured Ram on the opening kickoff.
And that is Ronald Wilson, the kicker himself. That's someone they can ill afford to...
It was a short kick, as we mentioned. Duncan fielded it at the 19, ran it back 16 yards to the 35, and that's where Morehead will put it in play. But first, we'll find out, if we can, what the situation is with Ronald Wilson.
I am wondering if he didn't intentionally try to avoid the vaunted Chris Cross.
Well, that could well be.
I wonder if we can get, I don't know if we have this on replay, but I'd like to perhaps see if we can see what happened during the kickoff return.
Well, evidently we do not have a replay of, well, yes we do.
All right, 76 is whom we're going to try and pick up. There's Duncan.
Didn't see.
It didn't happen at the tackle.
Nope, whatever it was away from the ball.
Well, Ken,
there was no evidence of it in the replay.
Nope. Ken, this is, I don't know how to describe my feelings because, of course, I want to see a good game and I don't root for either side, but I like both sides. I like both coaches. The kids on the team, the players, I talked to some of them this week and each said, hey, we're ready. We're psyched. Look out over there. And it's, I know that right now they're itching to play and it is unfortunate that we have an injury.
Well, Wilson is still down on his back, as you can see, right about the 30-yard line. It may well be that he was injured as somebody tried to block it, or did block him. That's what we'll speculate, but that is just speculation.
Well, the best news that I can tell you is that they're not working on his legs.
No, they're not that. You know, it may be that he had his wind knocked out, Bruce.
Certainly we hope that's all that it is. While we wait to find out, we'll take a timeout. And we'll be back after this.
Did walk off the field on his own steam. He had some support. We're underway, and the pitch goes to Chris Moyer, and he's turning the corner. He's got some room. There he goes. He's dragged down by an ankle tackle. The last man to get him. Wow. Otis Lynn makes a touchdown-saving tackle, and it was a one-hand on the ankle.
A 28-yard run by Chris Moyer on the first play from scrimmage. And
there you see the replay. Otis Lynn comes over, one ankle.
Just did get some of Moyer's ankle.
So back we go. Moyer again with the ball. This time nothing doing as the entire Rams team brings him down.
Well,
we've seen shades of the running and shades of the great defense.
All right, so Reidsville said, okay, you've shown us what you do. Now here's what we do. No gain on that one.
And that is true. That's one of the great, great marks of this game tonight. The matchups, the way they line up. One of the great strengths of the Panthers, of course, is their running game.
And one of the great strengths of the Rams, their running defense.
There you go. So it will be fun. Rodney Thurman under center. Lamont Duncan at fullback. They're in the tee. Chris Moyer is the tailback. And Thurman keeps it on the option. Chris Moyer gets it again, digging up ground. And goes forward to about the 30-yard line, close to a first down.
And the left side has been good to Chris Moyer in the early going. Another good gain, running wide to the left. Going to be about 2 yards short of the first down.
A long two at that. So it's third and call it three. There in the eye. Thurman pitches back to Moyer again, and he falls forward. He's going to be close to the first down. I think he's got it.
Yeah, I think he's probably got it with a yard to spare in there, Bruce. And it is a first down at 27.
You know, last week we saw the Rams give up their first score in 19 quarters, and that occurred in the second quarter last week. There you see the offensive line for the Panthers, Meadows, Phillips, Buffkin, Barham, and Atkins, as they line up now with a first and 10.
The right side of that line, the bigger on average.
And again, it's Chris Moyer,
And this time he gets forward to about the 25, so pick up of perhaps two.
Well, it's been all Chris Moyer so far. Morehead's run five plays, five carries by Chris Moyer, and 41 yards. There are the Morehead backs and receivers.
Antico Dalton is the, well, he's not only the tight end, but he is also the cornerback, or strong safety, rather, for the Panthers. Thurman, the quarterback. Duncan, of course, the fullback. Moyer and Petty alternate at tailback. It's still Moyer in there. If they keep this up, I won't need my binoculars. Thurman to throw, and he's looking downfield. The intended receiver was Kelvin Martin, and we've seen him do some things, of course, but that one was a bit overthrown. It'll bring up a third and nine. I guess I do need my binoculars. They are going to do things besides...
I had a feeling they would sooner or later.
I kind of did, too. There you see the mascot ramp.
In fact, I wouldn't be surprised to see Lamont Duncan carry the ball in the next play or two, as we've certainly seen him come on very strongly last couple of games. But he won't carry it this time.
Thurman drops. He's under a rook. It is intercepted. Intercepted by Sean Harrison. Thurman was hit as he threw it, and he threw a duck because of it. So the Rams defense has held. And now the offense will go to work.
Sean Harrison was right there. See if we have a replay. We may have later on. Reidsville's going to go right to work.
Yeah, wasting no time. Derek Hairston, lone setback for the Rams. And he gets the first handoff and picks up about two, falling forward, getting to about the 20-yard line. You know, one thing that may prove to be a difference in this game, because the teams are so tight and so close, is there we saw an example. Had the Morehead drive stalled, they were a little bit far for a field goal attempt, whereas last week we saw the Rams field goal kicker kick a long one, 40 yards.
Yeah, that could be important before we're finished.
Carter goes into motion. We've got a flag.
And somebody jumped. Tyrone Meadows moved along the Morehead defensive line. We'll wait and see if he was drawn offside. He wasn't.
He was not. That's a quick 5 yards. And it'll bring up a second and three. So, that may change the play a little bit. Now they're in the eye. Carter the tailback, Hairston the fullback. Carter gets the carry, and he's wrapped up at the line of scrimmage.
Tyrone Meadows, we saw him just a moment ago, very eager, jumping off sides. He was eager that time, too. He was in the backfield to meet Brad Carter.
Along with Greg Corbett.
And no offside that time. When I say Brad Carter, that's of course Brian Carter. Brad's not here tonight, that I know of.
And turn to the quarterback, blows out into the flat, and there he's hit Otis Lynn, and Lynn's wrestling forward. He gets out to about very close to the 30-yard line. Let's see where they spot it.
Pickup of six, first down.
Inches short of the 30, and they'll move the chains.
First down of the contest for Reidsville. And Lynn got the last couple of yards, got the first down yardage with a man on his back.
Brian Turner, the quarterback. Otis Lynn in motion. The handoff goes to Hairston. He bursts through the hole in the line. Gets forward for about 7 yards. A good pickup for Hairston.
Good power running by Hairston.
We saw him find one of those holes last weekend and go for 44 yards. There you see the offensive line for Reidsville. They've got some size. Jeff Meyer at 215. Todd Balsley, one of the smaller guys at 185. Coy Allen, the other little one. Look at Doug Robertson and Michael McCollum, 250 and 245. 6 minutes to play in this first quarter. And that's going to be close to a first down. Perhaps a yard short. That was Hairston carrying the ball, but it'll be, I think, a yard short.
As Reidsville again going for the power play, power running game up the middle. It's left them with a fourth and one, and what do they do?
And it's a short one, and we've got... they're going to measure, actually.
Well, yeah, they're going to measure, but I think they're going to find it short. We could get a look at the chain there on screen. That would be good. Well, we didn't, but we'll tell you it was a half yard short.
So the clock now back running at 5:48.
Going to go for it, as you see.
It's third and one. And again, Harrison gets it. I think he's got the first down this time. He appears to have crossed across the 40, if that isn't redundant. What is?
Yeah, it was third and one. They had fourth on the scoreboard. Fooled me.
There you see the Morehead defensive line and linebackers. Greg Corbett, we saw him in the backfield a little while ago. Kevin Thompson, Mike Jumper, Tyrone Meadows. Back into the single setback. Otis Lynn out to the side. Turner looks to throw. Throwing deep, looking for Nate Brown. Brown was open and went right through his hands.
Whoa.
I bet you Nate wants to just keep on running right now, too. We saw him. He is a gifted receiver. He is only a sophomore. He's got some terrific, terrific games in front of him. This is one that he could have had.
Yeah, folks, you might want to save the tape of that if you're recording, because you won't see that very many times in the next 3 years. Nay Brown had the defense beat. The pass was there, just wasn't meant to be that time.
Brian Turner right on target. This time it's Otis Lynn on the reverse, going to the right side. He gets forward for about five, maybe six.
Otis Lynn on the flanker around, we used to call it. Well, they may still call it that. Just outside the 45-yard line. Got four on the play.
Third and five. Got loose. He was going to be sacked. Now he gets it out to Harrison, and they turn a loss into a close to a first down. He's right at midfield.
Probably going to be a yard or so short, but a great play by Turner to get what he got.
They don't have the in the grasp rule in high school, do they?
Well, not in the same sense.
Because he would have been, I think. But he kept his wits. Very, very good execution there by Brian Turner, managing to stay on his feet and quickly dumping off the pass to avoid the sack.
And it is fourth down this time.
This time it is. It's fourth and about a foot, and they've got it in there. Plenty to spare. Harrison gets that first down, and they are now in Panther territory.
Well, you have to like Reidsville's chances on a fourth down and a foot, as long as they've got Derek Harrison in the ballgame. Third first down for the Rams.
3:30 and counting. Harrison again with the ball. This time he was bent in the backfield and got through a grasp or two and managed to get forward for perhaps a yard and a half.
Harrison, one of those guys who, like all the Morehead running backs, who always has his legs moving. Even when he's hit, he's still in motion, and if there's any opening there at all, he's going to get through it, as you saw that time.
Down to 3 minutes, second and seven. Lynn goes into motion up to the right. Turner drops back, throws left. He finds Sean Harrison, and Harrison's got some room.
Oh, a great move by Harrison after he caught that pass, Bruce.
Harrison was finally knocked down by Kelvin Martin, but wow.
He got around Greg Corbett, and then Corbett eventually caught up and made the tackle. What a fine run by Sean Harrison. However, we have a penalty on the play, and they're going to bring that one back.
Well, that might be a clip, considering the kind, the way that that play developed. But we'll wait.
Yeah, I think that's exactly what it's going to be.
Yep, there it is. So that's going to be costly. The Rams have been driving. You know, last week in their opening drive, they moved the ball smartly, but came away with nothing, largely due to a penalty. Second and 20. Back into the eye now. Turner under center. And he's going to throw. He's got time. Puts it downfield, finds Nate Brown at the 45-yard line. So that's going to make up some of the yardage.
Gain of 9 or 10 yards on that play. First catch of the night for Nate Brown.
It'll bring up a third and 8, but that's a reasonable proposition.
Turner now 3 out of 4 for 18 yards.
We're now down to 2 minutes in the first. Dumped off there quickly to Sean Harrison.
That's that same play again. This time Greg Corbett and a couple of other guys grabbed him and hung on.
And he's brought down essentially at the line of scrimmage. They might give him forward progress of about a foot or so, but not much. And that'll bring up a 4th and 8. And it'll bring up a punting situation. Sean Harrison will do the punting.
Reidsville ran 15 plays in that possession, Bruce.
Brad Bonds back in safety to receive it. A beautiful high punt. Wow. And Brad Bonds lets it go into the end zone wisely. That was a terrific punt. Had it stopped short, they could have easily downed it inside the 5.
Yeah, that was a case in which the bounce downfield actually was not good for the kicking team.
But that high, the altitude that he got gave the Ram defenders a chance to get down the field. A terrific punt. So, we have each had a drive. That is to say, the teams have each had a drive and no blood drawn yet. A minute 14 in the first. And now the Panthers will go to work for the second time this evening. Chris Petty at tailback along with Lamont Duncan, and it goes to Petty. He goes forward into the line and maybe picks up a couple, but not a lot there. There really wasn't much of a hole for him to try and penetrate.
Well, Petty got 1 yard, really, on his first carry of the night. A 2nd and 9 for Morehead.
Hand off to Duncan. Fake handoff. Thurman kept it, and then he pitched it out to Petty. That was a fine piece of ball handling. I thought Duncan had it, and so did some of the Rams defenders.
Well, a lot of people thought Duncan had it because they were busy tackling him as the play went outside, and that's going to be a first down Morehead at the 39.
Very well-run option play.
Third first down for Morehead.
Petty, the ball carrier, gets forward for a couple. Pickup of 2, maybe 2.5.
Ronald Wilson in on the stop for Reidsville. He obviously is okay.
And we're not going to get this play off. This quarter is coming to an end. 3-2-1. Whistle, and that's it for the first period. No blood drawn. The score, the Rams nothing, the Panthers nothing. We'll be back after this timeout. And you can see the players getting some of whatever it is they have in their little beverage bottles, water, Gatorade, what have you. And, Ken, we have seen some well-executed plays and some fine defense.
And we've seen in total yardage, unofficial, of course, in the first quarter, Morehead 62 and Reidsville 35 total yards.
Interesting how Morehead elected in the early stages to go with Petty. How many times in a row was that? Five? Six?
Well, Moyer it was. First five plays.
Thurman throwing downfield. Nobody there. He either saw good coverage, which there was, on his receiver, Calvin Martin, or...
Flag is down in the Morehead backfield. Watching the ball,
as was I,
so something may have happened after Thurman released it. Personal foul against Morehead, as it's turned out. Something did happen,
and probably our camera followed the ball also, so I don't know if we'll be able to pick it out, but that'll be a first down.
What did I say? Personal foul against Reidsville gives Morehead a first down at the Rams 44.
The stadium is about full this evening, as one might expect. Petty, the ball carrier, and he gets across the 40 down to about the 38-yard line before being brought down.
Nice pickup, 6 yards for Petty. Second and long four or a short five.
Take your pick. And there's a flag.
Looked like somebody offside in the Reidsville defensive line.
Yeah, I do believe that he was not drawn, but we'll see. It was Mike Atkins for the Rams. And it was an offside, so that'll move at five.
That's the third penalty against Reidsville. And that's going to give Morehead another first down, I do think.
Well, they're going to measure, I think.
Panthers have 4 first downs. Got the last one on a penalty and may get another one on penalty here.
Yeah, they're bringing it out.
Well, if it really was a short five to go, then this would necessarily have to be a first down.
And it is. So it's a first down for the Panthers. And a fair bit of this real estate.
So that is first down number 5 for Morehead. And the last two by penalty, which is not a good way for the defense to give them up.
Pitch goes out to Petty on the outside. He starts digging. Gets hit at the 30. Falls down at about the 29. So... not a bad pickup there either.
Petty up to 31 yards now on his first 5 carries. Moyer has 41 on 5 carries. Morehead piling up a lot of yardage, but that's all they're piling up so far.
Well, that interception on the first drive is what killed him. Of course, that was because of fine defensive penetration. Rodney getting hit just as he released. This time it is Duncan with the forward carry, and he's got a couple. He's down to about the 26-yard line. Of course, he may have stretched it farther than that on his fall down.
Quick hitter on the give to Duncan, and he got, well, yeah, he got down about the 26. We'll give him 3. Morehead started this drive at its own 20-yard line following a punt into the end zone.
Third and a long 2, short 3. Take your pick again. Thurman turns around to throw. Misses his man. That was intended, but well overthrown. Intended for Darius Lewis. On a little slant from the right side, but...
And Morehead yet to complete a pass, Bruce. An interception and 3 incompletions. So the ground game's been going pretty well. Not
the passing
game.
the defensive line and backers for Reidsville. Kenny Phoenix is not playing tonight. He was injured last week. But he normally is the starter for the Rams. It'll bring up a 4th and 3. And the Rams are going to go. The Panthers, rather, are going to go.
So this is our second 4th down attempt of the night. Reidsville made one earlier.
Flag goes down.
Against Morehead.
So listen to what the ref says.
What do you say, Bruce?
I knew you were going to ask me. Here, he'll say it yet. Here we go. There, did you hear him?
No.
I could hear his voice, I just couldn't make out the words.
4th and 7 now, and they're still going to go for it.
Betty goes in motion to the right. Rodney going to make a break on his own, and no goal. He is tackled there quickly. Good play by Mario Smith of the Rams. Number 30, Mario Smith came around, wrapped up Rodney, and so the Rams will take over on downs. Rodney didn't make a bad decision. It looked like he had a big hole there, but Mario Smith came on quickly and wrapped him up.
So the ball goes over on downs, and Reidsville will take over both teams. Morehead in its two possessions, Reidsville in its one possession. Both teams have run a lot of plays and gotten some yards, as you see Smith making the stop there. But we're still scoreless.
And Turner gives the pitch to Harrison. He runs to the outside, finds a hole. Still on his feet, still going. Finally pushed out of bounds. Antico Dalton makes the stop. Some of the Rams want a penalty, but Antico is just making sure he was going out.
And no flag is thrown. Now, wait a minute. A flag was thrown.
But they're going the other way.
But not the flag the Reidsville bench wanted.
Well, let's see. Holding?
Holding. 10 yard.
That'll cost the Rams 10, back to the 17-yard line. Reidsville has been penalized 4 times for 45 yards now, and they have a 1st and 20 to work on.
Goes in motion, and the give goes to Harrison, and not a lot doing there. He's wrapped up, met just past the line of scrimmage by Kevin Thompson for the Panthers. You know, this is such a big game, and I really like what Coach Johnson said earlier this week. He said, you know, both are good teams. We want to win. I hope we come out on top. If not, we'll congratulate them and we'll go forward. He says it's going to be a heck of an experience for both players, both sides players. And that's true. Turner drops back, tucks it in, runs. Now he throws again. And downfield is Nate Brown. Let's see what they give him. No, incomplete.
Evidently he was out. It looked like he caught the ball. It's a long way from where we were sitting. I think he caught the ball, Bruce, but he must have been out of bounds.
Apparently he came down out of bounds. Because the official who was, I thought, nearest was running up, and then the other one came from across the field and was signaling, nope. In any event, that'll bring up a 3rd and 17.
Brian Turner, 3 for 5, passing for 18 yards. And
all 5 of those passes, well thrown.
I expect to see him pass it again now.
And indeed, he rolls to the right, looks downfield, and off the hands. That time the tackle made Kevin Thompson again. And Brian's intended receiver, Marcus Harris, split end, but no go, and the Rams will punt. 8:16 in the second quarter, still no score.
So this is our first three plays in a punt situation of the night.
Sean Harrison set to punt again. Last time he got tons of altitude. Brad Bond's there. This time he's got a good deep punt moving over to the left, though. It may bounce out. Nope. Brad Bond's, though, not going to mess with it. And so the Panthers will take over on about the 38-yard line. Just over 8 minutes to play. No score. We'll take a timeout and be back after this.
Hi, I'm Tammy Moore.
And I'm Jesse Yates with Farm Bureau Insurance. How much insurance do you currently have on your home? Would it be replaced if you had a loss today, or would you be in a penalty situation?
To find out if you have enough insurance, contact one of our insurance professionals today for a free, confidential insurance review.
Come by and see us at 1917 Freeway Drive, or give us a call, 349-8486.
And you'll see why we say you don't have to be a farmer, just smart.
Much this year. After all, she didn't win a single race. She didn't break any records. And her relay team finished dead last in every meet. But Allie Schneider made a real splash simply by finishing every race she entered. Whatever you do in life, just do your best. From the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
So we're set to go now. Under 8 minutes to play. And it's Chris Moyer again at tailback. Lamont Duncan stays at fullback. The pitch goes to Moyer, looking for room on the left side. Gets around the corner. And he's pushed out of bounds by Todd Boyd of the Rams. You're right, Ken. The left side has been good to Mr. Moyer.
And that's going to be close to a first down, but I don't think it's quite enough. They're going to keep the football on the near sideline here and bring the chains over for measurement. Moyer now has 51 yards on six carries.
Well, it is going to be very close.
Well, here they come across field now. My guess is, Bruce, that's 10 inches short.
10?
10 inches short. We'll see. Well, we can't see. Yes, we can. Good
yeah,
camera work.
It's about 2 feet short.
Well, I don't think you can tell that from that angle, can you?
Well, I'm not looking at that. I'm looking through my glasses here. I was right on the line.
Looks like 10 inches to me.
All right, it's 10 inches that if you...
Well, it's a long 10 inches.
Yeah. I guess it works if your inches, 5 inches to the foot. There, now look across the field. Look at the spot and look at the chain.
Yeah, about 10 inches.
All right. 7:36 to play. It's a second and 10 inches. And Moyer goes to the right side this time, but nothing doing. Caught in the backfield there. Very well done by Otis Lynn, trapping a dangerous man. Good penetration by Otis.
And again, the play to the right side, not nearly so successful as Morehead has been running to the left side.
So they lose yardage, and it'll bring up a third and three. Goes to Moyer. He cuts back against the grain, and I think he's got the first down on forward progress. He was very, very close, knocked back, but I think if they give him the forward, it looked like the ball crossed that line, that 10-inch line you were looking at earlier.
Yeah, I think he's got it, Bruce.
They'll measure. And he did that one on his own. He was going for the left side, saw that it was going to be cut off. He cut back against the grain, knew that he didn't have a lot of time, but I think he made it up there to where he had to.
Well, they're bringing the chains out again. I think they're going to find this one first down with about half the football to spare. But
no.
They're not. No.
10 inches short.
Yeah, 10 inches again. On the angle we're sitting, we're not perfectly in line with the ball and the sticks, so that's why we sounded so foolish in declaring that a first down.
I didn't sound foolish. I said it depended on the spot.
Yeah, you sounded foolish.
And the Rams fans give their defense a hand. Fourth and one, the Panthers will punt. Set to do it is Ivan Moore. Sean Harrison set to receive. It's a fake. And it's Ivan Moore.
A great defense by Reidsville.
Stopped well short of where he had to go. Ivan Moore is the fullback. We saw him starting fullback earlier this year, so you know he can't run a bit, but that time the play was too slow in developing. He got going. He didn't get the pitch. Whatever.
Well, Bruce, I don't know what you said. You may have said the same thing I'm about to say. A great job by Reidsville in being aware of the possibility of the fake punt. They were not fooled, not for an instant. So a defensive star for the Rams that time. Is that what you said?
Well, no, I analyzed what happened. You said why, so there.
Well, I guess that works.
I guess. 6:20 to play. The Rams take over. They've got it on their own 44. They're in the eye. Turner gives it to Harrison. And he drives forward. Pickup of about 3 or 4.
Harrison has run it 8 times for 25 yards.
Nate Brown is wide right. Turner hits Brown. And he's on his feet, and he gets up there to the 30, to the 28-yard line. Good for a first down.
13-yard pickup. Turner now 4 out of 7. Nate Brown has caught 2 passes for 22 yards, and that is the 4th first down for Reidsville.
Clock moving at 5:28. There you see on the replay. Somehow he usually gets by the first guy.
He almost always gets by the first guy, does Nate Brown. Very clever with the football.
Well, Brown splits out wide to the left this time. Turner looking to throw. He's being caught, and he's sacked.
Greg Corbett grabbed him and wouldn't let go.
Yeah, the first guy to catch him, though, with his hands actually around his waist, was Matt Barham, who tugged him back and allowed Greg to get in.
Loss of 6 yards on that play.
Second and 15. Turner back to throw. Dumps it over the middle. Just a little dump pass to Harrison off his hands and falls harmlessly. Greg Corbett almost with a chance to pick it up, but goes down to the ground as an incomplete.
And Derek Harrison, a picture of disgust after that one went off his hands. Because if he caught that ball, he had a few yards to run, and he was really upset that he didn't hang on.
Well, that brings up a 3rd and 15. Passing situation. Harrison alone set back. 3 split wide left. Turner goes back, looks left. Got time. Hits Otis Lynn. Sean Harrison, rather. That's Sean Harrison out there. And he's going to be short of the first down. But possibly in field goal territory.
Got play carried to the 22-yard line. A 12-yard gain. As you say, not enough for the first down. The Rams may very well go for the 3 here.
Well, last week we saw Fred Luke kick a 40-yarder, and he's out there again.
This will be a 39-yard try.
The wind is calm, so that won't be a factor. The kick is up, and it is off to the right. I don't think it would have been long enough. Still, enough to give it a chance. The Panthers will take over, and we'll take a timeout. We'll be back after these messages. The score.
Chance trap by chance trap.
And we're set to go now. 3:37 left in the half. Moyer at tailback. Rodney Thurman throws it out right. He's got his man and still on his feet and going now out of bounds. That's Lamont Duncan, the fullback. We saw him take one of those a couple weeks ago, all the way, 80-some yards.
And that is the first pass completion tonight for Rodney Thurman. He's now 1-for-5 as it's first down. Morehead out 40 or the 39-yard line. 19-yard pickup. Well, I didn't spot him quite that far. We'll say the 38.
Nonetheless, a first down. And Duncan gets it and carries it forward. Pick about 2 yards, I think.
I think when they unpile, he's going to have three. But three is about two, so you were right.
Thank you.
And Bruce, unfortunately, it appears I'm not going to see my dream fulfilled tonight and see the stadium fill. Don't think we're going to make it.
Very close to it. Don't forget a lot of those empty seats in the band, which is making the way to the end zone. Thurman, trapped in the backfield, gets forward to the line of scrimmage, and that is all. Coming out limping for the Rams is Mike Smith. They have twisted his ankle a bit.
Third and six.
They go to the tee. Thurman pitches it out behind Chris Moyer. Moyer did well to recover, but that was the end of that ground gaining. So the Panthers will have to punt with less than 2 minutes.
Yeah, good job by Moyer, as you said, to get on that ball as quickly as he did, because there were Rams in the neighborhood.
And they were knocking on the door, and they weren't saying trick or treat.
Although they will be saying that in a couple of weeks.
One.
Yeah, one.
Well, you're close. One is almost two.
Yeah, one's about two.
Time called with 1:55. And so we'll take one as well. The score, no score actually. And we'll be back. Punt by Ivan Moore, but there was no fake, and the Panthers down it at the 38-yard line. So the Rams will go to work now. 1:46 on the clock, and still no score. Well, we knew that this would be a tough, close game. I'm not sure anybody expected it to be a tough, close, scoreless game.
Well, I didn't think it would be a high-scoring game because both teams play such good defense, but no, I didn't think it would still be scoreless this late in the half.
They each have fine defense, but they each have fine offense, and that's why it comes as a bit of a surprise. Turner throws outside to the right. The ball was tipped there and by Tim Martin, but it was Nate Brown, the intended receiver, and the tip threw just enough off trajectory.
And with the incompletion, Brian Turner now 5 out of 10.
But that's not bad. That stops the clock. Brown was going to be covered. Of course, the first guy misses him, right? The receiver split wide left. And the give goes instead to Derek Harrison.
Just trade a rock.
But time ebbs away on the ground gainer.
Reidsville had three first downs during their first possession. They've only had one since.
There you see them working on Mike Smith. Talked to Mike the other day. The give to Harrison again. He breaks forward. I think he's got the first down. If not, he's within inches.
It looks like he did get past the first down marker there.
But again, the clock. Now we've got a timeout called. Timeout Rams. I thought they were calling timeout. It makes sense to do so. 38 seconds. We'll keep this one here. On the sidelines, they're still working on what appears to be the ankle of Mike Smith.
Well, as you say, 38 seconds left in the half. It's first and 10. And we've already seen, Brian Turner evidently has his good arm tonight, Bruce. He's throwing the ball very, very well.
Yeah, his completion percentage is not the highest, but you and I both know that we've seen a couple dropped.
Yeah, that's true.
And have been caught.
And he's completed half of them, and that's not bad. And could have completed a few more.
Yeah, they were on target. Nonetheless, the situation remains scoreless. And, of course, the Rams with 38 seconds left would love to change that.
May Brown is way wide to the right.
Yeah. He's almost in the next county. It's a long pass just to him there on the scrimmage line. And he goes on the fly. Turner shakes off one would-be tackler, throws it downfield, and it goes incomplete. The intended receiver there was Sean Harrison, but falls harmlessly to the ground. 31 seconds now.
As Nay Brown drew double coverage that time, which, well, he really does almost every time, that time was no exception.
I asked Coach Clayton Johnson if he thought he might put a spy on Brown. Coach Charlie Griffin last week said that they thought they had put in some things that would contain him, and they didn't. And, of course, that was the winning touchdown for the Rams. So I asked Coach Johnson. He said, nope, we're just going to watch him close, but not a spy. Turner back to throw. Knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Knocked down by big number 74, Matt Quarum. 6'1", 255 pounds. Got a paw up there. And boom, down went the ball.
And they're giving Nay Brown lots of room in this stage of the game. Obviously, the worst thing you can do is let him get behind you. And they're giving him so much room that there's very little possibility of that.
Third and 10. Derek Harrison with the carry, and he gets forward to about the 46-yard line. But unless somebody calls timeout, that will probably end the half. Clock still running, under 10. Nobody calling it? Okay, that'll do it. Up. They called it with 2 seconds on the clock.
Interesting.
Interesting indeed. Well, now it's an all or nothing. Had they taken a pass down around the 20 or so, maybe a chance of a field goal, but now you got to do it in one try.
Yeah, and that's the obvious strategy. It gives Reidsville one more shot at it without giving Morehead any time to run a play if the Reidsville play fails. One more play, and we'll see what happens.
Unless there's a defensive penalty.
Unless that.
Of course, we can't have that. The bands are ready to go on, you know.
Don't go any faster.
I should say band singular. The Rams marching band will be entertaining the crowd at halftime. The Morehead band playing in the stands across the way. And I don't know. The stands on this side may not be entirely full, but you look across the way, it's SRO. I think you can count it a full house.
Well,
numerically.
There are lots of people here. There's no doubt about that.
So here we go. This will be the final play of the half. And Turner is being rushed. Gets good blocking, good protection. It's for Brown in the end zone.
He caught it!
Unbelievable! I see no... Oh, that's just... We saw him do it at the end of... the game last week. That one he did on a run. This one goes up in the air. Two defenders on him. We'll watch this replay, and it's something to behold. Nate Brown comes down with the ball. I was a little uncertain whether or not his feet were in bounds, but the official came down, put his hands up, and said, yeah, boy. There you see.
A 68-yard, or 46-yard pass, penalty flag on the point after attempt.
So, with no time on the clock, the kick.
There's a penalty
there's
on
a
the
penalty.
Point after. Against
and
Reidsville.
Against Reidsville, so that. Well, now the Rams are signaling like they want to decline it, but they can't decline their own, can they?
Well, no, you can't decline your own penalty. They'll have to try it again. The kick was good, but they'll have to kick over.
So Fred Luke will try it from a few yards farther. I love it. No time on the clock. Nate Brown catches a pass. Fred Luke now going to make the kick. This is the way football ought to be. And the kick is no good. Yes, it is good. Ken, did that kick look a little low to you?
Evidently it did.
Well, the officials were right there, but that was a line drive. So you see it, the score, 7 for the Rams, nothing for Morehead. This game is everything that was expected. Two wonderful teams, tooth and nail. We'll come back with the halftime recap after this.
The Action Sports Halftime Recap. The Halftime Recap is brought to you by A&H Wayside Furniture, your home furnishing center in Rockingham County, and by the Farm Bureau of Rockingham County. Helping you is what we do best. And by Crystal Chevrolet Buick Cadillac, your local hometown dealer where it's always worth the drive.
We're back now here at Rams Stadium. You see the Rams marching band getting out of the field. Ken, this has been one super game.
Pretty good one so far, Bruce. Why don't we recap the scoring?
All right.
With 2 seconds left in the first half, a 46-yard pass from Brian Turner to Nay Brown for the game's only touchdown. Fred Luke kicked the point after, actually kicked it twice. Kicked it once, and then an illegal procedure penalty forced him to try it again. The second time, he sent a line drive just over the crossbar.
I thought it was low.
And I mean just over the crossbar, but in any event, over the crossbar. That made it 7-0 Reidsville, and that's
the
score.
Scoring.
As far as unofficial yardage in the first half, for Reidsville, 33 rushing, 76 passing, 109 total. For Morehead, 92 rushing, 18 passing, 110 unofficial total yards for the Morehead Panthers. Individually, it was Chris Moyer, the top ground gainer in the game, as he ran 9 times for 50 yards for Morehead. Chris Petty had 31 yards on 5 carries. For Reidsville, the big ground gainer was Derek Hairston, 41 yards on 11 carries. Passing, Rodney Thurman of Morehead, 1 out of 5 with an interception for 18 yards. Brian Turner had 6 completions in 13 attempts. The biggest one, of course, that 46-yarder to Nay Brown at the end of the half. Total of 76 yards and a touchdown passing for Brian Turner. Nay Brown caught 3 for 68 yards and that touchdown. And that's what happened in the first half.
We should also say that when Nay Brown caught that touchdown pass, those 46 yards gave him a new Reidsville receiving record all time.
545 yards.
45 yards, and there's still a couple of games left in the
through
season.
Through 7.5 games of his sophomore season.
And he's got 2.5 games left in the season. Regular season.
Maybe more.
Maybe more. Well, almost certainly. Well,
certainly more.
The bottom would have to collapse for either of these teams not to make the playoff. They'd have to lose their next 3 games.
Well, that would appear unlikely.
Yeah, it certainly would. There you see some of the halftime activities, the Rams marching band. I'm trying to make out the design. Ken, can you tell what that is?
It looks like one of your bow ties, Bruce.
You know, I was going to say it looks like a bow tie. Well, I think it's in good... Oh, here we go. Pyrotechnics again.
All right.
In any event, this game has had pretty much the elements that we expected. A close contest, neither one taking a big edge from the other. But the defense, as we mentioned earlier, a little bit stronger than perhaps we'd expected on both sides of the field.
Well, you know, interestingly, there were some long drives as far as number of plays. Reidsville, for example, ran 15 plays in their first possession. Morehead had a 1-2-3-4. Morehead had a 12-play drive. But the field position starting the drives was such that even with a lot of plays being run, no touchdowns resulted until right at the end. Reidsville, by the way, on that final possession went 62 yards in 7 plays, with most of that coming in the last 2 seconds of the half. But there were a lot of plays run by each squad on most possessions. It was your Cleveland Browns used to play defense, Bruce. Bend and not break was sort of the story of the first half defensively.
Yeah, and that's that is the whole story. 7-0 in favor of the Panthers. I used to do that, but I didn't have the fire.
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
I used to do that without the fire.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that must have been boring. I mean, when you did it.
Well, I don't know about that. At any rate...
Do you have any tape of that, Bruce, that we could look at?
Ken, they didn't have tape in those days.
Oh, I see.
We will take a break now. That'll do it.
You have an artist's depiction.
I can make one, or a facsimile thereof, but not the same size. We'll take it. That's good. You've got me going now. That's going to do it for this halftime recap. But we'll be back with the second half of action after these words. Ram Stadium, and you see the score on your screen. Ken, we have had a lot of good football played, not a lot of scoring.
No, not a lot of scoring, but you don't need a lot of scoring to have a good game, and that's been demonstrated here tonight. As fine a half as we've seen this year, no doubt about that.
By both teams.
And the way the score did come, obviously, was in dramatic fashion. A long play with 2 seconds on the clock. That always serves to spice things up a bit. And second half probably going to be just as good, Bruce.
I expect so. So we're set to go. And there's the kickoff. This one goes deep. Bringing it up now for the Rams, Donald Graves. He goes out of bounds at about the 22-yard line. A penalty flag goes down.
So immediately we have a flag thrown.
And the Morehead Panthers appear happy, so perhaps a clip.
Well, we'll see. It presumably is against Reidsville, since the Morehead players are applauding. And it's going to be a long one.
Let's see if we can hear what the official has to say. We don't hear him say anything. But at any rate...
The official, a man of few words, Bruce.
Yeah, the Rams go to work from their own 16-yard line. Brian Carter in the slot to the left. And it's Derek Hairston getting the handoff, and he gets nothing.
Nowhere to go for Derek Hairston that time. Bruce, Brian Carter has only carried the ball one time, only carried it once in the first half, which is a little bit of a surprise, because he's usually, at least last week, he was quite a bit busier than that.
Top of my head, I would say he carried probably a third of the time anyway. Handoff goes to Harrison. He's caught in the backfield, this time for a loss. One of the first men to wrap him up there making the tackle was Kevin Thompson for the Panthers, so that'll bring up a third and 12.
As the Rams find themselves in a hole early, third down and long deep in their own territory.
Well, we're just underway here in the second half, and this game is a long way from over.
High formation on third and long this time.
Nate Brown over the middle, and it gets away from him, so that'll bring up a punting situation.
So nothing doing for Reidsville on their first possession of the second half.
This is their first punt, is that right?
Let's go back and look. No, they've punted once before tonight.
All right.
No, they've punted twice before tonight.
Nah,
this will be their third one.
That's right. Sean Harrison gets a good roll. Brad Bonds doesn't touch it. The Panthers will go to work from the 41-yard line.
33-yard kick from scrimmage gives Morehead pretty good field position to start this one.
You know, Ken, last year was the very first time in these two schools' history that Morehead was able to beat the Rams for the second year in a row. So obviously they never have three.
And for the first time, Morehead starts a drive in Reidsville territory.
And it's Chris Moyer at tailback with Lamont Duncan, the fullback. The pitch goes to Moyer. And he cuts back, gets forward, still on his feet, picks up about 4 yards, mostly on his own.
In fact, Bruce, this is the first time that that either team has taken possession of the ball in the other's territory.
Brings up a second and 6.
Good look at the Ram there.
Thurman drops back. He's being rushed. Now he tucks it in and goes forward. And he's about a yard or two short of the first down, but a good pickup for Rodney Thurman, the quarterback of the Panthers.
Piled up at the 33-yard line. It's going to be a third and 2-ish.
There's an official's timeout. There's a man down on the field.
A Morehead player has been injured.
You know, I didn't see him down there either, but the official was slow to see him. They were getting the sticks marked and everything, and then as he turned around, he says, oh, I guess I better call a timeout. Still can't identify him.
No, I am not able to pick up his number. Looks like they're paying attention to the right leg,
which is the last thing you want.
Here you get a look at some of the very, very large crowd gathered here tonight.
And on both sides, we might add.
Yeah, on both sides, indeed. Over on the Morehead side, the visitors' bleachers are pretty much filled, and a lot of standees over there.
Good news, because the player gets up. It's number 50. And that's Sean Law who is down. Sean is a sophomore.
Third down coming up for Morehead.
Third and 3. They go to the eye. And there's lots of contact. Lots of contact. They barely got set. And it goes against the Panthers.
Well, they can forget third and 3.
Yeah, that'll be third and 8. Coach Johnson not too happy on the sideline at this moment. Rodney gets the play, comes back into the huddle. Everybody's on the same page. 8:40 and counting. Still in the eye. Rodney back to throw. Puts it downfield. Overthrows Brad Bonds, who was triple covered, actually. And yet still had a shot at catching the ball. But that'll bring up a 4th and 7. A long seven at that. And Rodney, Ivan Moore drops back to punt.
Rodney Thurman, 1 for 6 now for 18 yards.
So it'll be a punt from the Panthers and back deep for the Rams is Donald Graves. And he's got it out to about the 15-yard line. Well covered by the Panthers. We'll take a timeout. The score, Reidsville 7, Morehead nothing. And we're back. And straight ahead goes Kerry. Pick up a 5 there for Harrison. This time it goes to Harrison again, and it's going to be about 2 short of the first down. So it'll bring up a 3rd and they're calling it 3rd and 1. It's a long one, looking at the spot. Nothing doing. Harrison tried to go up and over, and it was all stacked up. He came down on his feet and tried to go to the right, but then there were some Panthers there to stop him. So
we have a terrible angle here for judging whether or not he got the first down yardage.
Yeah, but the pillar and the angle combined, but...
But no, he didn't get it.
Well, he's a yard short.
So another punt?
Well, close enough to try a fake. Field position would preclude it, though, I would think.
So first downs are very scarce so far in the second half. In fact, they're so scarce there haven't been any.
That's pretty scarce, I suppose. Bonds back again in deep safety. Sean Harrison lifts a line drive deep. Bonds might return this one. He's got it, tucks it under his arm, and is dragged down singly. Excellent work there by Coy Allen of the Rams, brought him down on his own.
That was excellent work indeed, because we've seen how dangerous Brad Bonds is in the open field. So a very, very fine tackle.
On the trade of punts, the Rams gain a few yards. The Panthers starting out from their own territory. 6 minutes on the clock. There in the tee, it's Moyer and Duncan. Handoff goes to Chris Moyer. He gets out to the 45-yard line before being tripped up.
Fake pitch and then the inside handoff to Moyer.
Pick up a 5.
Moyer now has 59 yards on 11 carries, and he's doing the bulk of the work tonight for Morehead.
In the tee again. Same play. Moyer gets forward, and he's got the first down and more.
Exactly the same play. And a very similar result.
Picks up 6 yards with this one, so that'll bring up a first. That's the first down of the half. With over half of the quarter gone, 5:12 and counting.
Seven first downs now for Morehead.
Panthers now on the tee. Pitch goes to Moyer. This time he goes left side and gets forward for about 4 yards, perhaps 5. I'll tell you, if you can get 4 or 5 yards or 6 yards a pop, why change?
Well, a lot of guys have made a lot of money getting 4 or 5 yards every try.
Well, a lot of guys have made a lot of money getting 4 something, but not many have done 5.
Well, John David Crow did in 1960.
Career average. This time Thurman drops back the pass. He's being rushed. Eludes one. Eludes two. Now he throws it downfield. He's got Brad Bonds over there, and it is complete. And that's not Brad Bonds. I take that back. That was Kent Petit. I'd say that Petit. Kent Petit.
Petit is, I think, a good guess there, Bruce.
Not a receiver who gets a lot of passes. There's that turnaround play again. This time it doesn't get nearly as much. The Rams defensed it well that time. Under 4 minutes now in this third quarter. The Panthers trail by seven. The Rams, there appears to be a penalty. I don't see a flag. Nothing marked off. Some of the Rams were signaling like to decline. This time it's Lamont. No, Thurman keeps it on the option, and he doesn't get anywhere. Nothing doing there.
Well, he got a yard, if he got a yard. If he got anything, it wasn't any more than a yard. And really, he didn't get that. Third down and nine.
So we'll see what Coach Johnson sends in. They go to the tee. The stands are rocking and rolling. Thurman rolls right, being rushed, and he's sacked. He is sacked. Ronald Wilson, the first man to hit him. Mario Smith right there behind. So the Rams defense holds, puts a sack on Thurman. Should also mention good downfield coverage by Sean Harrison, and Rodney couldn't throw the ball.
The first time that Thurman has been trapped for a loss tonight, and it brings up an obvious punting situation.
Ivan Moore back. Donald Graves just going to let that one go. It rolls into the end zone and will be a touchback. 2:13 on the clock. The score remains Rams 7, Panthers 0. We'll be back after this. And the crowd is happy. Set to go now. The Rams go to work. A little over 2 minutes in the third. They're on their own 20. Pitch goes to Derek Hairston, turning the right side. Gets up, picks up about 2 yards before being upended. Making the tackle, Kelvin Martin for the Panthers. Well, the defenses have gotten even tougher, Kent.
Indeed they have, and they were pretty tough in the first half, and they've been even more effective in the second half. Morehead did come up with a couple of first downs on that last possession, but immediately thereafter, Reidsville's defense put a stop to it.
Brown spit wide left. The handoff goes to Brian Carter, and he's got some yardage. He's close to a first down.
He's fumbled the ball, and Morehead has recovered.
He's fumbled the ball.
After a good run, a 9-yard pickup, the ball popped loose.
I didn't see him fumble it. This pillar and I are going to have words before it's all over.
Watch the replay. There it goes.
Yep.
It was Antico Dalton made the hit that knocked it loose.
Down to about a minute now. They're in the tee and whistles. Flag goes down. And the Rams are cheering, so looks like the Panthers will start with a first and 15. See if we can pick up what the referee says.
Illegal procedure.
He didn't say it very loud, did he?
Now he's not exactly a chatterbox.
Under a minute now in the third. There in the eye, Chris Moyer, the tailback. Thurman back to pass, throws it downfield, looking for Calvin Martin, and it is incomplete. Double coverage there. Well covered.
And good, good, effective defense.
Scott Hackett and Donald Graves, the double covers there on Calvin Martin.
And the pass defense executed just the way it has to be done.
Yep, waiting for the ball to arrive. That stops the clock with 42 in this third quarter. You know, except for 2 seconds, there has been no scoring in this game.
That's right.
Second and 15. Thurman rolls right, pitches to Moyer on his horse, gets back about 7 or 8 yards. Past the original line of scrimmage, but it'll bring up a 3rd and 8. Or even 9, they're calling it.
Chris Moyer with 77 yards on 15 carries. He's run the ball well, but so far hasn't produced any points for Morehead.
Got flags and some of the Rams jumped, but I didn't see any movement by the Panthers. There may have been, since two of the Rams jumped simultaneously.
Offside against Reidsville.
So that'll bring it back to a more manageable situation, a 3rd and 4.
All right. He spoke right up that time.
Yes, he did.
So from a 3rd and very long to a 3rd and sort of long, but that's the end of the third quarter.
So we will come back to finish this one. 1 quarter left to play. You see the score. The best is coming. Hang on. We'll be back. We're back now to begin the fourth quarter. Ken, not a lot of statistics, I wouldn't think, out of the third.
No, not a heck of a whole lot if we check the unofficial total yardage through three quarters. Morehead 137, Reidsville 127, but only about 35 yards total offense in the third quarter.
Set to go now. Panthers in the eye. Moyer gets the handoff and finds a hole. Bounces off a tackle. That's it. That'll go in. He bounced off a tackle. I don't know how he stayed on his feet, but once he broke loose, he's one of the fastest people in the state. You knew he was going in.
Just a great individual effort by Moyer.
When we see this on the replay, he gets hit hard. So now a very crucial kick will be attempted by Ian Moshinsky.
What an effort by Moyer.
Ian, the place kicker.
Not only
timeout there used by the Panthers, they didn't have enough people on the field. That may prove costly.
Not only does that put Moorhead's first points of the night on the board, it puts Moyer unofficially over 100 yards rushing for the evening. Something he's not unaccustomed to. Morehead went 70 yards in 5 plays for that score.
So they'll talk about it a bit. Becomes a very critical kick, obviously. Moshinsky is there.
Let me correct myself. 30 yards in 5 plays. That's a little different from 70.
And the kick is up, and it's good. We're tied. So it's a brand new ball game. just under 12 minutes to play. Hot diggity dirt. Don't go away, folks. We'll be back after this. And we're back now. Bruce Michaels along with Ken Eccles, and it took 3 quarters and 8 seconds for Morehead to get on the board, but they did it in a big way. Chris Moyer with a terrific run, second effort, bouncing off a tackler, and then taking it in with that speed that he's got, and the net result is we're tied.
Well, there have only been 2 scores, but they've both come in impressive fashion.
And there's a pretty good kickoff down to the 5, taken there by Donald Graves, and gets through one tackler. He's got some real estate. Finally knocked out of bounds there at about the 37-yard line.
So a good job by Donald Graves gives his team a pretty good spot to start from, its own 36-yard line.
Stephone Williams was the man who bumped him out of bounds. And so the Rams go to work from the 36. 11:45 on the clock. The score is tied.
As you see the run back.
The electricity is thick. Fumble in the backfield. I think the Panthers got it. We'll see what they say.
So for the second consecutive possession, Reidsville has fumbled the ball away.
That was recovered by Scott Carter for the Panthers. First fumble was very costly. Until then, they had held the Panthers scoreless. And again, they take over
just
excellent field position.
Same as last time, Morehead takes over at the Reidsville 30-yard line. As you see the replay, last time they ran 5 plays from the 30 and scored. And it goes without saying, the Reidsville defense now has to come up big.
Chris Moyer is still the tailback. Lamont Duncan is at fullback. Moyer gets the carry. And he goes forward up to about the 25-yard line. So good pickup again for Chris.
And it's, Bruce, it's been almost all Chris Moyer in the Morehead backfield tonight. We've only seen Chris Petty for one series, as I recall.
Well, Chris Petty is an excellent back. He really is. And I think everybody knows that, certainly all the defensive coaches. But Chris Moyer is one of the fastest people in the state. I think that's what Coach Johnson might be looking at. And it is going... It is. He's going in for a touchdown. The pass from Rodney Thurman to the fullback, Lamont Duncan. That's the second time we've seen a touchdown pass completion to Duncan. And bang, bang, just like that, within the span of a minute and a half, the Panthers have scored twice.
And both times following fumbles at the Reidsville 30-yard line.
Suddenly, except for the cheerleaders, the Rams side of the stands fairly quiet. Not hard to imagine why. That's not a grinded out drive that you see coming. That's 2 quick scores. Kick is up. Derek Harrison almost got in and blocked that point after, but it is good. The score now 14-7. The Panthers in front. We'll take a timeout, and it just gets better. Hang on. Well, Ken, you know that we're down to nitty-gritty time. 10:32 on the clock. Of course, we know that the Rams can score often, vigorously, and from any point on the field. We've seen them do it, and of course last week they came from behind with that wonderful drive that they moved up the field against Western Guilford.
Well, yeah, they certainly, all the game certainly is not over by any stretch of the imagination, but it's really tough, though, when you play such good defense as Reidsville has done, and then give a team 2 possessions at your own 30-yard line. You can't get away with that.
Yeah, it's disheartening. It's kind of a squib kick. And touched and then picked up. Otis Lynn touched the ball, got away from him. He did recover it, but then he was forced to retreat as the onslaught of Panther defenders was coming towards him. And he ended up being down at the 20, just outside the 20-yard line. So it'll be first and 10 from there. And the Rams go to work with 80 yards to go. In the I formation, Turner drops back, looks left, and he hits Sean Harrison there, who's taken out of bounds at about the 24 or 25-yard line.
4-yard pickup, third catch of the night for Sean Harrison. 7 out of 15, Turner is now, for 80 yards.
You know, Turner throws a good line drive pass. That's not a bad means of moving down the field.
Indeed not.
Splits wide left. Brown wide to the right. They're in the eye. Turner back to pass again. Eludes one tap. Humble. And Morehead has recovered it again at the 15-yard line. And I think the Rams have got to be shell-shocked.
Wow.
Unbelievable. And we have a man injured on the play. It's a Panther.
Well, there
it's like
it is.
Jumper, but he's back up.
Batted ball, batted loose, and the inability to hold on to the ball continues to plague Reidsville. This time, Morehead taking over even deeper in Reidsville territory at the 15.
Well, this time, instead of just being covered, they picked it up and ran with it, and it's inside the 20. First and 10 Panthers, 9-11, 9-10. In the tee, still Chris Moyer. And there's that play we saw a couple of times earlier this half. And Moyer picks up nearly 10 yards. I think he'll be just short of the first down.
Well, they're going to spot him at the 10-yard line, which will leave him about a second and five.
Well, I guess my eyes are playing tricks.
112 yards for Moyer.
This time, well, I was about to say he was caught in the backfield, and ultimately he was, but again he bounced off some tacklers.
Well, what you saw that time was a great effort two ways. A great effort by Moyer to get away from that initial trouble, and then just first-class pursuit by the Reidsville defense to make sure that once he got away, he didn't go anywhere.
These are two of the finest teams in the state, ladies and gentlemen, and they're going at it head-to-head. Something to behold. Thurman rolling right, now flips it out to Moyer, and Moyer fumbles it. Nope, it's being called an incomplete pass. Moyer was decked on that one. He's slow getting up. In fact, he may go out.
Thurman now 3 for 10, 59 yards and a touchdown. And it's a 4th and 11 for Moorhead.
So Mushinsky may get the call again. This one will be from about 32 yards out. I think that's about his outer range. It's blocked. And it is blocked, so back and forth, the momentum swings. 7:37 to play. The Rams will come back with that much time, trailing by 7. We'll be back after this. Wow.
And what a job, Bruce, by the Reidsville defense after that fumble.
Well, we knew that both sides can play this game, and they are showing it, and they're showing the heart. Turner on a roll to the left. Got some time, looks downfield, overthrows his man. The intended receiver was Sean Harrison, but just too high for him to reach.
Turner now 7-for-16 passing on the night.
Second and 10. Harrison splits wide right, Brown to the left. Carter in the slot to the left, and Turner on a roll to the left. The throw, Nate Brown hits his man short of a first down.
But just short.
He got it to about the 35. He'll be about a yard short. Almost two, actually.
Well, they're still walking around with the stick, so it's hard to say. I think they've settled on a place now.
Yeah, just outside the 35, so about a yard and a half. The clock at 6:50 and counting. Rams down by 7. And that'll be a first down. Well done. Derek Harrison takes it forward. That'll move the chain, so the Rams go again.
Harrison, 17 carries and 52 yards, and for Reidsville, Bruce, that is their first down of the second half.
Ken, if you look at the lights, you can see the excitement hanging in the air because it's so windless. Turner rolling out to the right, being pursued. Decides to keep it, tucks it under his arm, gets up close to the first down. Crosses the 45-yard line. He'll be about a yard, maybe too short, but I think he was pretty close to it before being sent down.
Very close indeed. It's going to be a second and quite short.
A short one. Time now under 6 minutes. Harrison single setback, and he gets the carry, got the first down and more, gets it out to midfield.
So two quick first downs for Reidsville.
Same formation. Brian Carter in the slot, Brown to the right, Harrison to the left. Oh, off the hands of Sean Harrison. And he thinks he should have had it, and he's probably right.
Might be premature to mention this, Bruce, but we haven't seen an overtime game this year. I don't think there's been an overtime game in the Triad 3A this year, has there?
Not to my knowledge, no.
Well, of course, we're not tied right now, but... could happen.
Point differential is set to possibly have one. Turner, take handoff, rolling left, throws it downfield, intercepted. It is intercepted by the Panthers, picked off by number 5, Tim Martin. And now the Morehead side has gone crazy. And there is a flag on the play, so hold everything.
Well, if this stands, and we don't yet know if it will, if this stands, it will be the fourth consecutive possession for Reidsville that's ended in a turnover. And it's going to stand.
Unsportsmanlike, it's the white team, be first and 25.
It was a dead ball foul against Panthers for unsportsmanlike conduct, but after the intercept, so...
Well, evidently talking trash after the interception. So that means Morehead will start with a first and 25.
Be first and 25.
25. That's not what the coach wanted to get.
That really, that kind of takes a little bit of the luster off the interception.
Yeah,
you're happy because
sure
you got the ball, but when you start first and 25,
That's really up like a punt for the Rams, which of course is not what they wanted, but a heck of a lot less damaging. Dumb thing to do. Dumb thing to do. Well, they made their hole. Now they'll try and get out of it, and
not much there.
Devin keeps it, but not much doing is right.
The second and 22.
Under 5 minutes now. Still long yardage, second and 22 as the Panthers break the huddle. There you see Coach Ted Jones. Rodney Thurman throws it downfield. A heck of a hit after the intercept, well, not after the incompletion. Lamont Duncan, the intended receiver, and he was de-cleated, Ken.
I should say so.
We knew this would be a terrific game, and it has lived up to all of its expectations.
Thurman now 3 of 11.
Third and 22. And it's Chris Moyer, and he slips and goes down, and so the Panthers will have to punt, and the Rams will get the ball back. Still plenty of time.
And so the unsportsmanlike conduct penalty after the interception very definitely comes into play here. Morehead with a first and 25 when they took possession and could not convert.
Rams have a couple extra players on the field. They managed to get off in time. The punt is up. It's a nothing punt straight up in the air. Takes a good Panther bounce, though, crosses midfield, comes to rest at the 44-yard line. Ivan Moore not probably proud of that one, but he got a good roll out of it. So the Rams will go to work on their 44, 3:50 to play. We'll come back after this. And we're back. 3:28 and counting. The Rams must score at least 7 to tie. Turner rolls to the right. The ball goes incomplete. The intended receiver there was Otis Lynn. He wanted to go downfield to Nate Brown, but he was being well protected there. On defense for the Panthers was Kelvin Martin.
And Brian Turner has now thrown 20 and completed 8 of them. One for a touchdown.
Second and 10. Harrison catches the screen, and Harrison's got some room. Harrison along the left sideline. He's down at the 33-yard line, finally upended there by Tim Martin for the Panthers. That's the spark that the Rams were looking for.
That is a gain of 25 yards on the pass to Harrison. And it was a pretty basic play. Harrison set up in the backfield as though to block. Then he let his man slide
by. You see him put the block, and then he jumps out.
Then he swings out, takes the pass, and has lots of room.
So a first and 10, 2:50 now on the clock. Turner throws left, and he still on his feet. Oh, my gosh. Sean Harrison showing some bobbing and weaving and juking and some Houdini moves. I'm not sure how he got free.
But he did. And a big, big play sets up Reidsville with a first down just at the 10-yard line, just outside the 10.
But is it outside or inside?
I think he's just outside it.
Number
just like that, Reidsville helps itself to 43 yards on the last two plays.
From this angle, I cannot see the nose of the ball. The nose may be touching the 10-yard line, or it may be about 4 inches short, which could make the difference between the potential first down inside the 10.
Turner is now 10 for 22 for 130 yards.
He's had a good night passing. Several of those passes dropped.
And Harrison's had a pretty good night, too. He's caught 4 for 39 yards. Nay Brown, the leading receiver, yardage-wise, he's caught 4 for 77.
Folks, if you remember last week, we had a barn burner down to the end. It looks like it's going that way again. A couple of great games here. Now the Rams return to the eye. Nay Brown in motion to the right. And Turner on a timing pattern into the end zone. From being tied, Ken.
And another outstanding catch by Nay Brown. In traffic, caught the ball and managed to stay in bounds in the corner of the end zone.
Well, that was just perfectly executed. That was a timing pattern. Brian Turner released that ball well before Nate turned to look for it. The defenders, of course, didn't really know it was coming.
Well, it was perfectly done by the passer and the receiver.
Fred Luke's kick is no good! The kick is no good. No flags. Oh my gosh. Fred Luke has got to feel. Well, you can tell. So, the score now 14-13.
So, from euphoria to a bit of consternation for Reidsville as they still find themselves a point behind with 2 minutes and 31 seconds left in the game.
What happens, Ken? Onside kick?
Probably too early for that.
Well, now the Rams crowd is on its feet, but then again, so are the Panthers fans. 1 point separating, 2:31 on the clock. Oh my, oh my. Chris Moyer and Lamont Duncan back in the safety, deep safety position, set to receive the kickoff. And this one's one of those going all the way. So much for that.
Wow.
I guess that was not an onside kick.
If it was, it was not perfectly executed. Ronald Wilson again showing you the power he has in that leg. So Reidsville will, in essence, turn it over to their defense now and say, get us the ball.
Yep, and I'm sure that the ball handling members of the Panthers have been reminded, hang on to the ball. Well, the prospect of a tie is pretty much gone by the boards. And a penalty flag goes down.
There goes Morehead backing up again.
Yep. So again, they start behind the eight ball a bit. First and 15 it will become. Should they be forced to punt, the Rams in all likelihood will have good field position. From the Panthers' standpoint, they desperately need to get a first down or two. And now we've got a timeout called for some reason.
Well, it's...
The officials have gathered to look at the ball. They didn't like the spot.
And another thing to bear in mind right now is if Reidsville is able to stop Morehead without a first down, they'll likely get at least decent field position. And remember, Fred Luke has at least 40-yard field goal range.
Right. Well, so now they line up again. First and 15. The give goes to Chris Moyer, still on his feet, digging forward, hanging onto the ball. He crosses the 20, out to about the 21. That'll bring up a second and, what, nine or so. A good pickup, but that penalty is costly.
Yeah, exactly. When you're starting first and 15 or first and 25, as they did last time, makes it tough.
Timeout has been called. Didn't see who it was charged to. We'll take one, too. The time is 2:19 on the clock. The score, Morehead 14, Reidsville 13. Don't go away. Well, I'll tell you, Ken, 2 weeks in a row, I don't know if my heart can stand many of these.
Yeah, we are getting a little old for this.
Again, the ball carrier again gets over 5 yards. He lost the ball, but they're saying he was down, and I do believe that was right. He was on his back when the ball squirted loose, and if he's on his back, that I think is down.
Well, yeah, that's the call, and that's what the book says. He got it to the 27-yard line, still short of a first down.
By about 4 yards, so they'll have a third and a long four.
Clock stopped at 2:07 to play.
Well, if that was a Reidsville timeout, they must not have many left. I didn't see the official signal.
Well, I think it's probably safe to guess that it's Reidsville who stopped the clock. I doubt that Morehead would be that interested in stopping it right now.
Morehead needs a play. Reidsville needs to stop it. Crowd's cheering defense. Chris Moyer again gets the ball, stays on his feet, crosses the 30-yard line, which would mean they've got the first down.
I think that he was just able to extend his arms and get the ball across the 30, and he was.
And again, he lost the ball as he fell onto his back, extending his arm, but again, it was after he was on his back.
Moyer now has 123 yards tonight.
That was second and third effort by Chris Moyer.
23 carries for that 123 yards, averaging just a bit over five per.
Mario Moore coming out now for the Rams, limping a bit. Under 2 minutes to play, first and 10 Panthers. And it's Chris Moyer again, the ball carrier, and again he gets 5 yards. Apparently the five-yard machine.
Well, these last few plays, it's just been a case of we'll give it to our guy, and we think he can do the job. And right now, Moyer is doing the job for Morehead. Clock at a minute 16.
And you know, he is doing it, too, because, I mean, he is, because the blockers, the tacklers are all around him as he's making those yards. It's Moyer again. This time, well, not this time. I don't think he made it back to the line of scrimmage.
No, Reidsville stopped him for a loss of a yard.
But we're under a minute and ticking. 45 seconds.
Rams cannot stop the clock.
And the Panthers are in no hurry to put it in play. Third and five. And in fact, they can sit it out. 30 seconds now. They've got two plays to waste. Chris Moyer again, and
kind of surprised.
I had a hat on it. I didn't knelt down.
Yeah, kind of surprised to see him risk a handoff.
The clock does stop at 19. Apparently the Rams had the one timeout left, so they saved it for that moment, and in fact that's why they did the handoff, and that means that the Panthers will have to punt on a fourth and five. Oh boy.
So Reidsville still with a life here.
A gasping 19 seconds, some of which will elapse during the punt. Ivan Moore, who has not punted particularly well this evening.
And Reidsville, of course, thinking block.
Thinking big time block.
They'll give him the all out rush.
And this is his best punt of the evening. A nice high punt comes down on the 35 and is down by the Panthers on the 36 yard line. And so the Rams will go to work. They have 11 seconds. Well, they had 2 seconds in the first half.
It's been done before.
What do you want to bet they put 17 guys on me?
Well, we know Turner can throw it. He's got a lot of guys who can catch it.
And he does this one out of bounds to stop the clock.
Which, of course, he had to do in that situation. So they have 8 seconds left. And
well,
Morehead strictly in a prevent situation now.
Yep. Four defensive backs at their own 40. And ready to backpedal. I don't think you'll see a lot of pressure on Brian. 8 seconds. Here's the ball game. Brian throwing deep downfield for Nate Brown. It is picked off. No, it is not. Antico Dalton almost picked it off. Number 10 met number 10.
Still a second out there.
There is a second on the incomplete pass. Antico Dalton almost picked that one off, and Nate Brown put the helmet in there. Just why are we booing? What's the?
I'm not sure what they're upset about.
1 second. We've seen some unbelievable finishes. Brown and Harrison split wide left, as does Brian Carter in the slot. Brian Turner is dumped. Brian Turner on the last play of the game is sacked by Scott Carter, and that's the game. Brian Turner's still down, but he's not hurt. He's hurting inside, I'm sure. The Morehead Panthers have won for the third time against the Reidsville Rams consecutively. For the very first time in these two schools' history, Ken, the score 14-13, it just doesn't get any closer. We'll come back and wrap it up following these messages. Well, folks, we knew it would be a terrific game. And in fact, it was an epochal struggle, Ken, just something to behold. And as Coach Johnson said, it's a shame someone has to lose a game like this.
Well, let's quickly run down the second half scoring. All of it in the fourth quarter. 11:52 left in the quarter. Chris Moyer ran 25 yards for a touchdown. 10:32 left in the quarter. That touchdown, by the way, that was produced by a 30-yard drive after Reidsville fumbled at its own 30-yard line. Next possession, Reidsville again fumbled at its own 30-yard line. Morehead went 30 yards in two plays. The score coming on a 25-yard pass from Thurman to Duncan with 10:32 left in the game. The kick made it 14-7. Reidsville came back to make it close. They drove 57 yards in five plays, scored with 2:31 left on a 10-yard pass from Turner to Brown. The point after touchdown attempt failed. That left Reidsville down 14-13, and that is the way it ended, 14-13, Morehead's way. Unofficial total yardage for Morehead, 156 rushing and 59 passing for 215. Reidsville, 67 rushing, 140 passing for 207 unofficial total yards. 1 point difference in the score, 8 yards difference in the total offense. Individually, the big gainer individually was Chris Moyer. He carried the ball 5, 10, 15, 20, 26 times for 129 yards and scored a touchdown. For Reidsville, Derek Hairston gained 55 yards on 18 carries. And big night receiving for Nay Brown. He caught 5 passes for 87 yards, 2 for touchdowns, and he set an all-time Reidsville receiving yardage receiving record, single-season record. I'll get this said one way or another. Nay Brown has now set a record for most yards receiving in a single season for Reidsville. He's now well over 600 yards with his total tonight for the season. Sean Harrison also caught 4 passes for 39 yards. Brian Turner was 11 for 24 for 140 and 2 touchdowns, and that's the way it went.
It was a night of great performances and great effort. All of the players digging down deep for everything within them. And I absolutely know that no one could possibly feel worse right now than Fred Luke, the kicker for the Rams. Sometimes you miss a kick. Sometimes it happens. You just hate when it happens in a game like this. But that was the difference in the game.
Well, what he needs to do and what he will do is bounce back from this and remember that Reidsville still has an excellent season going and still has a good deal of football to play. So he'll have plenty of opportunities to redeem himself.
He needs to remember that last week's winning margin was, in fact, 3 points. He got that 40-yarder, so he wins sometimes, too. They'll come back next week, and they'll do okay. We'll be back next week as well, following this Reidsville Rams team, as we follow them to Rockingham County and the Cougars, and that will do it for this night. For Ken Eccles, I'm Bruce Michaels, saying have a good weekend and a great week, everybody.